I stand before you, the holder of the keys. A great many of the mysteries of our order are known to me, our secrets laid bare before my eyes. It is I, and I alone, who can grant passage to our most inner circle, who can judge the weak from the strong, the truth from falsehood. I alone bear the Book of Salvation, the sacred record of our unforgiven past, and of the torturous road we have trodden to absolve our great sin. I alone know the names of all those who have fallen from the Emperor's grace and have returned to him through repentance of the soul or absolution of the body. I alone bear the most terrible burdens, for on my shoulders sit the sins of the Dark Angels Legion, and I cannot rest while they still remain to stain our honor.
Ezekiel serves as the Grand Master of the Dark Angels Librarius during the 41st millennium. Recruited into the fold of the First during 516.M41 on the world of Delphina III, the visions of the chapter's librarians warned of a society steeped in barbaric rituals of human offerings to the Emperor. Deploying four companies to investigate this ominous planet, the Dark Angels observed the altar towers constructed from human remains looming amongst the wilderness. Culling the tribal peoples with blade, bolter, and purging flame, the crude fortifications constructed by the barbarians fell until only its largest, Serengast, remained. Its inhabitants mute and placid in nature, the Delphinians of Serengast welcomed the Angels of Death into their settlement. Master Astofel of the Fourth Company requested assistance from the chapter's librarian and met with Codicia Meroth to divine the reasoning for their change in demeanor. Sensing an immensely powerful psychic presence deep within the stronghold, Meroth found within the deepest dungeon of the keep a child of 10 years chained and marked with branding scars. Reasoning the boy had pacified the people of Serengest, Meroth looked into the aged expression of this unfortunate soul, whom had languished until his salvation, seeing visions of emancipating angels. Tested by the chapter's chaplains and librarians for signs of weakness, the young boy never faltered in his trials and succeeded in ascending to the ranks of the Dark Angel Scout Company following his surgeries. Proven in battle after many campaigns as a scout, Codicia Meroth enacted the testing to further appraise his innate talents. Exploiting Ezekiel's greatest fears with immense psychic assault, within the Well of Sanctuary, the trauma Meroth witnessed caused him to scream and collapse. Debilitated for 80 solar days, Meroth never spoke of the horrors he had witnessed, and once recovered, deemed Ezekiel fit to join the Librarium, for no terrors he could inflict would surpass those already endured by his protege. Bypassing the rank of Lexicanium entirely, Ezekiel's time spent as a codicia would also be short-lived at only 10 years of service. Promoted to the rank of epistolary and exceeding the rank of Meroth, this savant of the arcane could never fully be trusted by his peers by virtue of his immense power and spent much of his time studying alone within the librarium. Fiercely loyal to his chapter, despite the scrutiny of his battle brothers, Ezekiel proved invaluable in battle. Venerated for his valor during the War of Groblenik during 949.M41, his efforts at the Battle of the Sularian Gate prevented the Greenskins from advancing. Struck in the left eye by a ricochet bullet of an orc shooter, Ezekiel's injury allowed for the orcs to press their assault against the Dark Angels 5th Company and Vestroian Firstborn. Groblenik took to the field, confronting the still wounded Ezekiel, fitted with a crude augmetic eye, which would be dubbed as the Eye of Vengeance. Repelling the Greenskins with flame-wreathed strikes of his foresword, the orcs retreated in terror as Ezekiel's psychic powers filled their minds with panic and dread. Dueling Groblenik and claiming his own left eye as reprisal, Ezekiel decapitated the Xenos and hurled its head into the Greenskin hordes. Routing the orcs in their entirety, Ezekiel never replaced his rudimentary bionic eye, for many regard his decision as a way to respect and remember those that fell at the Sularian Gate. Appointed as the Grand Master of the Librarium following the battle, its previous bearer, Denathium, stepped down from his senior position for the betterment of the chapter. Hesitant to trust this somber soul, the inner circle of the Dark Angels, though unanimous in their sanction of his promotion, regardless stood uneasy in his presence. Rarely speaking above a whisper, Ezekiel's reputation as a ruthless commander and powerful psyker is well earned. The holder of the keys guarding the dungeons of the Rock, entrusted with among the chapter's darkest secrets. Guarding the Book of Salvation, which lists the names of every fallen angel recaptured by the interrogator chaplains of the chapter. This tome of immense value is kept on his person at all times. Wielding the mastercrafted force sword, Traitor's Bane, which harnesses his incredible psychic power. Some within the chapter claim trapped souls of the fallen slain in battle further hones its edge and grows darker in appearance within their presence. Further armed with the mastercrafted bolt pistol, Deliverer, and the Artificer armor, Secret Shield, this ceramite suit rivals Terminator armor in its protective qualities. Rooting out weakness in the chapter's logistical and military capabilities, Ezekiel must protect the inner circle from treachery and continue the hunt for the fallen. Feared by all within the Dark Angels due to his sinister nature, Ezekiel must judge every member of the inner circle before their appointment as Grand Masters. His skill as an interromancer, causing his enemy's sanity to fracture. There are few warriors more terrifying in battle than the holder of the keys. His eerie stature, befitting such a champion, for a chapter as enigmatic as the Dark Angels.